G'day everybody, it's Maroon here. You are listening to the Legends of League podcast, coming to you as always from our studio at the Four Pines Brew Pub in Manly. Enjoy the Four Pines. You can get it from the comfort of your home. The team at Four Pines have you covered with free delivery on juicy burgers. That's right, burgers. And beautiful fresh cold beers as well. fourpinesbeer.com.au/delivery for more information on that. Now, joining us this week for our Legends Wrap, Geoff TOOVES Toovey and the mighty Steve BEAVER Menzies. Let's do it. It's the Legends of League. Well, hello and welcome to another Legends of League podcast. Today we've got some fair dinkum Manly royalty joining us today, which is wonderful as we head closer and closer to NRL finals time. Firstly, a bloke with me who played over 280 games for Manly and the Northern Eagles for a couple of years too. He's a very successful coach and a colourful identity of rugby league. Of course, the one and only, the toughest man, weight for age, Geoff TOOVEY. Nice to see you, old mate.
Good to be here, Maroon. Nice to be in these sunny quarters here down at Manly.
Yeah, beautiful. Beautiful part of the world. And on the Zoom today in his office in Homebush, another Manly great, a bloke that played over 470 first grade games, most of those with the famous club, Steve BEAVER Menzies, in his office in Olympic Park. G'day, Beav.
G'day, boys. Beautiful to be here down in downtown Olympic Park.
Yeah, mate, I don't want to get off on the wrong foot, but when you came on the Zoom and you couldn't hear us yet, Geoff TOOVEY said that you wore that tie to your school formal. Is there any truth in that, eh?
No, I didn't. No, there's no ties in my school formal. This is pure business. I did it myself, Toobs.
So you knew that. Now tell us about the elephant.
No, the trunk's up, so it's good luck.
Good luck, good castle. Luck.
Nice. Yeah. Because the trunk was up.
And before we go any further, boys, I should mention this new one we've got here, the Nitro Pavlova Ale. This is a great stuff. If you haven't had a crack at that, Toos, I'm going to give you, because you're going to work on the ferry and you can polish them off on the ferry.
Oh, it's a good day for it, too.
Yeah, bloody oath, it is always a good day for it. Boys, let's talk a little bit of footy with you guys specifically. I want to look at the results from round 18 and then have a look at this round coming up. The Rabbitohs beat the West Tigers by 26 points to 24, and the Tigers look like they're going to finish ninth again. But the Rabbitohs, it's a worrying sign, Toos, when they're letting sides back into the game.
Yeah, it is, but I watched that game closely. I just think they got too confident maybe, and they just thought, oh, we'll take the foot off the accelerator. I still think they've got plenty of improvement in them, and I think they could be a dark horse. I said it several months ago. If they've got all their players fit, they're my dark horse. Mm.
I guess, you know, much could be said about a lot of the top teams. What about you, Beav? How do you see the Rabbitohs? Do you see them as genuine contenders?
I've done a little few markings here, and I really only think there's four teams that are contenders. I think the good teams, yeah, you saw the off the back of last week, and we'll go through the results. The big four teams, Melbourne, Roosters, Panthers, Canberra, who know semi-finals are around the corner, they start ramping up leading into it. I just think Souths need to do it mentally. You just can't do what they did on the weekend and expect to get the semi-finals and flick a switch and just turn it on. I just think they need to do it this week, or it's going to be hard.
That's interesting there, Toovs, that Beaver said the top four sides. He's left Parramatta out of that equation.
Not the top four. I'm saying the top four are ramping up. Parramatta's coming fourth, but they should be going to another level this time of the year. It's just that how much experience, finals football experience, do those players have, and how much do the others have? And that just shows me that the other teams know semi-finals are around the corner, and that's I suppose, my comment, Toobs.
Yeah, I disagree a little bit, Beav. I just think that you need some big-name players in your side. I think that's what you're alluding to as well. I think Alex Johnson coming back for the Souths is a big boost for them, even though they're missing Latrell, which is a massive loss. Mm. But I just look at the teams, I look at Parramatta, and said, who's going to be their standout player? Who's going to be the one that takes them to the next level? And that's what you mentioned, Beav, as well. I just can't see them. Where the other sides have got those world-class players that have been around for a long time. So I just think there's some sides there that
Gutherson's
they're missing.
Key for them. I think Gutherson's probably their man to do something is exceptional.
Boys, this next game, now I want to spend a little bit of time on, put the spotlight on this one. Manly beat the Doggies 32 points to 20, but hasn't been Manly's year. Some people will say that they have too many injuries to keep players, which they do, and they have had on and off throughout the year. But then also, too, some people might say maybe they're relying too much on one or two players and one of them's injured.
Well, without a doubt. I mean, that's the nature of the game now, particularly those clubs that haven't got the resources to bring a SBW in, like, you know, with two rounds to go. I mean, you know, anyway, but that's the area that they're missing. They're lacking that quality of depth, whereas those sides that have been in the semi-finals for a long time, they have those depths and they have those resources to have the depth. Someone like Tom Dravojevic out is a massive blow for Manly, and I think since he's been out, it's been tough. The two front rowers got injured and one suspended, I think, a few weeks ago. And I think they're probably a bit burnt out too. They need a bit of help.
Dave?
Yeah, look, the way Tom Trebovich, the way he plays for Manly, he's not just a fullback. He jumps in at first receiver. He's pushing on the inside of DCE. He's involved in a lot of play. So you take someone out like him and they lose a lot of their cohesion and just that they're disjointed sometimes when something should be fluid and a break is a try because Tommy's involved. You know, that instinct and you're missing it sort of.
Beave, what you're talking about too is, I think, is the confidence he brings because, without him there, they just go, oh, you know, we're flat. Oh, what's going to happen now? Yeah. Who's going to score our tries? You know, that's what it looks like to me from not being involved there. But he brings so much confidence and pizzazz and an X factor. And all of a sudden, the Garricks and those guys, those lots of name players, they're all of a sudden scoring tries and doing great things because they've got that confidence that they can do it.
And I think they had that a little bit last year when Tommy was out. I think they all sort of stood up. They had a confidence. They're on a better roll. They didn't have as many injuries other than him. And they're all going, let's all do it. And they're all playing well and they're winning games. So I think it is there. They're just, maybe you said, they're just too many injuries, just a couple short.
Boys, when you were playing with some of those great Manly sides through the 90s, one of your great arch rivals. You always had a great, and every team did, with the Bulldogs. Now we look at the Bulldogs this year, and they've won two games all year. They've been flogged a number of times. They try their heart out, and then there's problems at board level. Toovs, when did the Bulldogs become this mad woman's breakfast of an NRL club?
Well, it's hard to say, but I mean, a lot of people are pointing towards, the fish rots at its head.
Yep.
There's a lot of conjecture around who's leading the club off field. I'm talking about whether it be the Leeds club or the football club. So there seems to be a bit of a power struggle there at the top as well. Again, unless you're involved, you don't know exactly what's going on. But they need to organise it. They need to get some depth there now. They need to get some new exciting players, which I think they're looking towards doing that. But you can't do that if there's chaos in the back sheds or in the office.
All right. Beef, Penrith 30, Penrith 20 beat Parramatta 2. Now, for Penrith, they've lost one game all year. They've had one draw. There's still this train of thought in rugby league, do you think, Beef, that they need to lose again before the grand final, before they go on and win it?
Well, the Parramatta fans are saying that. Confidence is a crazy thing. I think if they have an off game, even if they win, I think that'd be good kick in the butt enough for them. But you would never want to say, let's lose a game. But it's a little bit like that. I would prefer to go into semis playing some hard teams. And don't get me wrong, Parramatta is a tough team, rather than playing easy teams and winning 20-2. They need a couple of close games to get their heads on, get them ready for semis.
Yeah, but I think they're a grinding team, Parramatta. I don't think they're a flash team with some pizzazz. I think they're a really drag them out, bash them up sort of team. And once they were matched there by Penrith, they had no plan B. They were stuck there. So if someone's going to match you in that toughness and that grind out game, who's going to be the one that's going to be the X factor, as I mentioned before?
Yeah.
Who's going to be the one that's going to take you over the line and score the tries when it's so evenly matched? And I can't see that at Parramatta at the moment.
Okay, what about
change the momentum? Someone to swing.
Yeah, exactly.
In your favour, and then everyone gets on board. You just need a couple of key guys to do something big, whether it be a big hit or a half break. Then everyone gets energy. Then everyone takes over.
What about Penrith, boys? Because you look at Penrith, they've got arguably the buy of the year, Appy Coruscant. Manly probably wouldn't have, well, they wouldn't have let him go if they knew what was about to happen. And then you got Cleary and you got Luai. But then you go one way, you got Kikego. The other way, you got Liam Martin. They, you know, not they've only lost the one game, but they're a great side to watch, Toovs.
They're a fantastic side to watch. They're in great form. Their confidence is high. They've got a mixture of youth and experience. I can't see anyone apart from the Roosters possibly matching them this year. They are sensational. And the old story, oh, we've got to lose a game before we can, you know, before the grand final. I don't think that's right. I think they'll just go on. They'll keep going on.
Yeah. Do you see Penrith Beavers being the favourites?
I still think the Roosters are the favourite, just because of the experience and what they've done. But Penrith and the Roosters, yeah, I'll probably toss in Melbourne, just under them. Yeah, they're the three for me that are going to...
All right, boys, Raiders 37 beat the Dragons 8. Now, we're talking about sides that are attractive to watch when they're on a roll. Obviously, the Raiders fall into that category. But let me start here with you, Toovs, with the Dragons. The Dragons have just named a new coach, which would seem a sensible deal, 2 to 3 seasons. You've coached at NRL level, right? You've coached at Super League level. If you're Hook, if you're Anthony Griffin, you go in there, the Dragons coach, what's the first thing you need to do?
Well, in my opinion, and they've been doing it in the last few weeks, they need to settle on a team. Like, who is going to play fullback? Is it going to be Dufty? Leave him there. Who is going to play in the centre? So leave him there. Who's going to play hooker or half? Just have some steady combinations there. Don't swap and change every 2 weeks because someone's had a bad game. We need to get some consistency there and build on that. They just need those players to be stuck in those positions for a while.
Mm. And Beav, what about you, mate? The Dragons, certainly in some key positions. They keep chopping and changing, as Toov said. But they've certainly got names. They've got enough big-name players there that they should be playing finals footy.
Yeah, and Toov's has hit the nail on the head there. People just need to know the positions and stay there. And like you said, they've got enough troops, they've got enough cattle. When they're playing well, they look good. So it's a funny thing. Sometimes it's a mindset change or something little that can, and maybe it's a couple of those, like we said before, about someone being a bit of a leader on the field to change momentum, to get everyone else on board. It's a fine line between playing ordinary and doing well as a team. But unfortunately, they're just on the other side of it at the moment.
I think you're right, Beav. I think they need to bring someone into their team, particularly for next year, that's going to make that difference that you just mentioned. I think it's too late, though. I mean, who's on the market that's going to make that difference from? Is there someone that's disgruntled at the Broncos? I don't know. I don't see anyone on the market that's going to make that difference to them. That's a problem.
Boys, this next game, obviously we're all behind the Titans at the moment. They've won 3 straight. Holbrook seems to have created something there now, and he's got some big names coming to the Gold Coast Titans next year. And it'll be great to see them being successful because it's been, you know, slim pickings there in the last decade. But the Broncos, now they've only won 1 game since we got back from COVID. You can't make this shit up that's gone on there at Brisbane, have you? We've had a coach in quarantine. We've had coaching staff in quarantine. We've had players breaking quarantine. A key player signing with another club. The 5-year coach being punted after 18 months or whatever it is. Who should coach the Broncos, Toovs?
Well, I'm a bit biased because I know him, but I think Kevin Wallace, he's the coach. He's smart, done a great job with the Queensland team. And I just think that he'll bring them all together as a tight-knit group, which seems to me is what they're missing. At the moment, they're all playing. I said it about 5 months ago. They've got some great athletes in their side, but they've got not enough football players. Look, they've got to come together as a team and sort of try and get motivated and try and get enthralled into the game of rugby league and play some football, not just that I'm a really fast athlete or I'm big and powerful, I'm going to run over the top of people. Just play some footy and have some fun.
Yeah, but see, Beav, some people might say that's all well and good, but if they bring in Paul Green, just to be the devil's advocate here, he's coached sides in a couple of grand finals. If he gets them winning, all that's going to happen anyway.
Look, I'm no coaching selector, so I'm not going to say who should or shouldn't be a coach. I think just what, like, they've got an amazing squad. They've got amazing athletes, like Tu said. They just need a bit of cohesion, so we're all not playing for ourselves. We're playing for each other, as in if the other guy's doing the header, he needs two of us pushing to, you know, to get a quicker play of the ball. Or when we're going here, how can I help my teammates? And just a bit of self-belief in where are we heading as a team? What do we need to do? Let's all believe that and get on board. And it starts in the training paddock and builds through when it's they can do it. They just need a coach to pull them together.
Is it fair to say they need a big hug? I think they just need a big hug. And, you know, and I think Kevy can give them a big hug and say, come on, let's play a bit of footy, you know. It's not all lights and whistles and flat. Just get down and play some footy. Give me a hug.
Just enjoy your footy. We do this because we love it. I'm hoping so. But, like, get out there and have a game plan that's not too crazy, really simple, but do it because we enjoy it.
And as you've coached NRL at the highest level too, let me ask you this again. For Anthony Seibold, when it started to get for six losses, seven losses, eight losses, then the players go AWOL, yada, 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 how hard does that job become?
Well, it's like a disease, isn't it, winning and losing? I mean, like we talked about Penrith before, they could be down by 2 points and with 10 minutes to go, and they said, oh, it's all good, we'll win here, we'll win here. The other way around, you would be in front by 2 points if you're the Broncos, go, oh no, they're coming back, here we go, we're going to lose. Invariably, you lose. Hmm. So, as Beav said, you need to be confident, you need to be having fun, but as soon as you break that run of losses, well, then you've got to convert that into winning, win, win, win.
Yeah.
But, breaking that run of losses is a very difficult thing.
Yeah, and Beav, are we? Why are we all assuming it's going to be Paul Green or Kevy Walters? Is there some other name we should throw up at this job?
I don't know. Someone that's sitting near you, potentially. I don't know. Is that what you're suggesting?
Would that be a good job, do you think, mate?
I think it'd be a great job.
But you've got everything at your disposal.
Oh, they've got all these resources. Yeah. And bells and whistles.
Five-year deal, too? So will you take the five-year deal?
How much commission, Beav?
All right, boys. Roosters, Knights. We won't spend too much time on this one. Roosters 42, Knights 12. But obviously, Beav, if teams want to whinge about how many injuries they've got this year, fair dinkum, the Knights, you could put another team together with who they've got on the bench.
Yeah, it's been a tough year for them. It's such a promising start to the year, halfway through the year, and it's really turned around, and they're sort of limping literally into the semi-finals. The Roosters, on the other hand, really starting to ramp up. I think everyone sort of give them a couple of crosses a couple of weeks back, was it maybe a month or so ago when they lost a couple of key guys for the season. But for me, they're still the benchmark.
Do you find it strange, Beav, that he rested players? Newcastle, they rested players, or did he feel that they couldn't win either way, and so he rested them? I mean, to me, it's a really funny thing to do before a big game against a title, someone you might have to defeat to win the title, and you're resting players. I've found that very, very strange.
Yeah, it's a little bit strange. I suppose only he would know how bumped and knocked around they are, and mentally if they needed a week off, but like on the outside, you're right, it does look a bit funny.
Melbourne Storm 36, North Queensland Cowboys 20. Toovs, the North Queensland Cowboys the last couple of years are a fair dinkum. They are a vegetable lasagna. You don't want to watch them. You don't want to call them if you're a commentator. But they get a bloke here who's really proved himself as a coach, Toddy Payton. Where's it going wrong for the Cowboys?
Oh, well, I'll mention one thing, JT. Mm. Oh, that's right, he's retired.
Yeah.
Look, he brought so much to their side, even though it's a great roster anyway, don't get me wrong there, and they should be doing better, I believe. But once you take, we mentioned before about Manly with Tom Trbojevic, you lose one of those key players, JT, forever, then everyone looks around, well, who's going to be the next bloke to stand up? And I think it was Morgan who was there. They're looking for someone to be that leader to replace JT. And unfortunately, there's no other one like him. So it's going to take them a long while to recover from that hangover of him retiring.
But how long can this be an excuse? I mean, he's been missing a couple of years already.
Yeah, I think it's probably about now, and it's not that there isn't great players. No, it's probably.
Oh, I agree with you, Beav. I agree with you.
There's probably great players, but it's just the aura and the leadership that someone has on the field, not necessarily by shouting or doing stuff, but just his presence can be there that they miss, and they can't. They're not feeling that from under someone else. They just need to, they've had a bit of time, but you need to learn to play without someone like a Cliffy Lyons or something like that. That's a sad day.
Cronulla 22, New Zealand Warriors 14. It's all been said about the New Zealand Warriors. Who would have ever thought, Toovs, that the New Zealand Warriors would be the side that sticks to their guns, that plays for 80 minutes, that wins the games that they never should have won? You know, they've won 7 games, or is it 8 now? I think it's 7, since the COVID crisis. Since they've been based in Australia, they've won 7 games. They've lost players along the way. They've sent players home, and they're still winning.
Look, can I say one thing? New Zealand are my second team, right? The Warriors are my second team. They just let me down every year. Every year. I'm so confident we're going to do well. They've got a great roster, and they just seem to fail at the last hurdle all the time. This year was probably a little bit the opposite, sure. And they fell. But the effort they had in coming over here, being away from their friends and families, living in a strange accommodation for the last 5 months, hats off to them. They've been fantastic.
All
absolutely
right.
Fantastic.
So you think that their adversity that they've had to undergo this season will give them confidence for next year? Is this something that is going to be the catalyst to push them up to be a top four side?
Well, Beave, as they are my second team, as I mentioned, I hope so. But they let me down every year. Every year they let me down. So hopefully something will change.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, from what I'm hearing, they're going to be here next year anyway. So if it's living in Australia that works, you know, apparently they're going to be – there's a very good chance they'll still be here based in Redcliffe. But, boys, let's have a look at the games for round 19. We're running out of time here. Beav's got a very important meeting because that's why he's got his – I just thought from while there, Beav, you might have become a Mormon and you're going around knocking on doors with that tie on.
No, you'd be good at that too, Beav.
It's got
the elephant's trunk.
Elephant.
No, we love it. We love it. Okay, boys, quick as you can with this one. It's nothing. I don't think there's going to be too many upsets here. Rabbitohs, Doggies, Thursday night.
Rabbits.
Beav?
Rabbits.
Cowboys, Panthers. That's the Friday 6 o'clock game.
Is this a loss they need to have, Toovs, or not?
No. They don't need a loss. Okay. They're flying.
I'm tipping the Panthers.
Yeah,
of course. Heck.
All right. Parramatta versus the Broncos.
Ooh, this could be an upset. I'll tell you now. I think the Broncos could upset.
Parramatta are going to win.
Oh, please.
Okay, Parramatta Eels fans, this is the week I need the Eels to
stand up
to show me that they get. Yeah, that's right. I think it's
by how many? How many, Beav? How many? By how many?
Oh, they need to win by 18, okay. 20. I think after a loss. They need to
be
a different week mentally. I think they need to get out there. This is going to show me. Yeah.
But just quickly here, Toovs, you said you can see an upset.
Yes.
Let me ask you, where do you see that upset could happen? Where are Broncos' strengths?
I think if they're having a fair dinkum crack, the Broncos.
Yep.
They will match them in the forwards.
Right.
I think they've probably got a better forward pack than Parramatta, in my opinion. And then if they just play a basic game, I think that they could match them there. And if you're close enough sometimes, Maroon, you're good enough.
Okay. Now, Gold Coast Titans going for 4 wins in a row, as they said on the Sunday show. The last time a team on the Gold Coast won 4 games in a row at any sport, it was the women's Coits team back in 1924.
Really?
And they take on your Manly Sea Eagles Beaver.
Well, I'm sorry to say the women's Coit team from 28 are going to keep the record because the Seagulls are going to win.
Yeah, I can't see Manly losing.
Mm-hmm. Storm West Tigers.
Storm.
Storm.
This should be a good game. Roosters Sharks. The Sharks will aim up.
Look, are we gonna see Sonny Bill on the field or just him panning on the sideline? Yeah, no. He played the last two games he played 10 minutes each, but he was on the TV for like 50 minutes. Can we watch the football?
Have you got any issues relating to SBW that might go back a few seasons?
Forward pass maybe in the grand final.
All right, so you're both gonna go Roosters there?
Roosters.
Yep. Canberra Raiders, New Zealand Warriors. What about this one?
Well, go, Beef.
I think the Raiders, I think they're ramping up. I think off the back of last week, good win. I think they know how to lead in the semis. I spoke about it. I think it's really important for the key sides to do this, and I think they're experienced enough, what they went through last year, to ramp it up, and I think they'll tough win, but they'll win by 16.
Yeah, Ricky will have them primed for this one. Bit of consistency. They need some consistency going into the semis.
Okay, boys, just in a word, this one, Knights, Dragons.
Knights.
Knights.
Righto, boys, before you go, I know you've got to go, Beav, quick as we can, we'll ask you this question. Who was your rugby league idol growing up?
Mine?
Yeah.
Mine was Graham Eady.
The Wombat.
The Wombat. I had the wormhole with the number one on the back, and then slide down Brookie Oval.
He listens to this podcast too, the Wombat. We love him. What about you, Toovs?
Well, you know, I had a few, but, you know, I think growing up, I liked Johnny Gibbs. I just like he was a crowd favourite on the hill.
Yeah.
Hair flowing in the back, head back, blonde locks, local boy, Narrabeen Junior. Yeah. Good on him.
Yeah, good on you, fellas. Manly Legends are one of the great Sydney clubs, and we hope they're around forever, playing at the mighty Brookvale. Beav, thank you so much for coming on Legends of League podcast, and all the best this afternoon with your work. And Toovs,
thanks, mate.
Good on you, mate. Toovs, you better get. There's a lot going on in the COVID world for you accountants. But you better get back into it, son.
I love it.
Okay, don't forget to take this for your trip on the ferry. That's got the nitro pavlova. I put this in the Chevy, and it's like it's on rocket fuel. So you have a crack at that, mate. You might be playing halfback.
Well, I get off the ferry is the big thing.
you might jump
just
off.
Just go back and forth till I finish.
Well, you better take the lot then. If you're going to do that, you better take the lot. Righto, boys, we'll see you, and we'll see you next time on the Legends of League podcast. Well, that's it for another week of Legends of League podcast. And once again, thanks everybody for all your support, talking about it to your friends, telling them to have a listen, see what we're all about. Thanks to our brand partner too, Four Pines Brewing Company. Now, you can give them a follow. We'd appreciate that on social media at Four Pines Beer and the website fourpinesbeer.com. Next week, it's Throwback Thursday. Toovs is back with us, but we'll be joined by a good mate of mine, Mark Spud Carroll, and he'll be via Zoom as well. When he's not jet skiing these days or working in his gym, he likes to talk a bit of footy. Now, be sure to subscribe to the Legends of League podcast so you never miss an episode. Show us your support by rating the show or leaving us a review. And you can see all the best bits and all the big announcements too at Legends of League AUS. That's Legends of League AUS. We'll see you next time on the Legends of League podcast.